Hello students, in the last lecture we have discussed about the nutrition. Now in this lecture, on the basis of nutrition we can classify the organism. We'll be discussing about that. So on the basis of nutrition we can classify organisms into autotrophs and heterotrophs. ये तो आपने पहले भी पढ़ा होता है. Okay, autotrophs. First, we'll be taking care about the autotrophs. What are auto and trophs? Auto means self. Trophs means नरिशमेंट और न्यूट्रिशन. मीन्स आम भाषा में हम कहते हैं, इन ए लोकल लैंग्वेज इट इज इन 8th क्लास इट इज गिवन द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच कैन मेक देयर ओन फूड. मेक देयर ओन फूड मीन्स वॉट? एक्चुअली द डेफिनेशन शुड बी द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच कन्वर्ट सोलर एनर्जी into chemical energy. Chemical, or you can say food energy. Food is a chemical. Okay? It should be very much clear. So, वो organism जो solar energy को convert करते हैं into chemical or food energy, they are called autotrophs. कौन है ये? Obvious, green plants हैं. Why we are taking green plants an example? Because they have chlorophyll. Already you have gone through this pigment. This pigment have a capacity. What kind of a capacity? A capacity to trap sunlight. Its function. Pucha jai chlorophyll ka function kya hai? To trap sunlight. Okay. Now, क्लोरोफिल हमें समझ में आ गया. ऑटोट्रॉप्स इसलिए अपना खाना बना पा रहे हैं, या ऑर्गेनिज्म दीज आर कन्वर्टिंग सोलर एनर्जी इनटू फूड और केमिकल एनर्जी बिकॉज दे हैव ए क्लोरोफिल. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड वेयर एग्जैक्टली क्लोरोफिल इज प्रेजेंट. वील यूज द 9th लैंग्वेज ऑल्सो. द नॉलेज ऑफ द 9th इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द क्लोरोफिल इज प्रेजेंट वेयर? इट इज प्रेजेंट इन, यू नो दैट इट इज क्लोरोप्लास्ट. In chloroplast, where exactly it is in present in the thylakoids. Now, chloroplast kahan present? Exactly where the chloroplast is present? Ye question likhne mein, dekhne mein 1 mark lag raha hai, but it can be of 3 marks. Why? Let us understand. We are going to find where chloroplast is present. Okay. Now, in the NCRT, there is a diagram which has been given. Transverse section of the leaf, sorry, longitudinal section of the leaves, which is being cut it. Here they have made xylem, phloem, and there is a midrib, means venation structure is being given. And if we cut a longitudinal section with the blade, a very, very thin part of the leaf we cut and see in the microscope, we will find there is a layers of cells. The first layer of cell is flattened cells. These are flattened cells, right? And these flattened cells are development from the parenchyma, and these are called as epi. Epi means outer, derma means skin, so name is given epidermis. Epidermis. Above that there is a waxy coating. There is a waxy coating called as cutting. Below this there is another modification of the parenchyma tissues. And these are basically elongated cells making a layer. Let's make it double layer. Why we are making double layer? There's a reason for that. Reason is the chloroplast basically is present in the cells of this layer. So make circles in the double fine layer. These are, we are showing chloroplast, correct? This layer is called palisade layer. Palisade layer. So if question comes, where exactly the chloroplast is present, you have to say they are present in the cells of palisade layer. Now, below this palisade layer, there are loosely packed cell structures making a layer, loosely packed, very loosely. Intercellular spaces are, a lot of intercellular spaces are present. This is called spongy layer. This is called spongy layer. Even cells of spongy layers also have few of the chloroplast. But if the question comes, where exactly chloroplast is present, you have to write the cells of the palisade layer. If question comes, if the spongy cells of the spongy layers have chloroplast, answer is yes. Below this, there is inner derma, means skin. Inner derma of the skin, of the leaf. This is called as endodermis. This is called endodermis. Endo means inner, derma means skin. This is spongy layer. Now, endodermis is not continuous. In between the endodermis, there are certain openings are present which are called as stomata. I hope you have understood this longitudinal section of the leaf also. The diagram itself is having 2-mark value. Without that, with that, if the question comes where exactly the chloroplast is present in the leaf, then with this diagram, you have to write in simple straight line, the chloroplasts are present in the cells of the palisade layer. I hope it helps you. Thank you so very much.